We're going to tell you about that.
Getting around the joints.
It's amazing. It's so delicate and so fragile. It reminds me of a really favourite, slightly worn ballet shoe. They were always the most comfortable and the most lovely to wear. And what is extraordinary is that the delineation of the toes and the whole, it's like a second skin. It's quite amazing. And very, very personal.
Well, it is your second skin.
It's a second skin to my foot, which is, of course, the ideal for any ballet slipper. It's really extraordinary.
I first came to Ireland in, I think it was 58, as a very young, probably the youngest corps de ballet dancer in the Royal Ballet at that time. And
in those days, you travelled in the boat, so you would come into Dunleary and take the train up into what was Westland Row. And until very recently, when they renovated the station, there was still the wonderful black and white paving on the platform. Sadly, I think they got rid of it. But that always brought me right back to my first morning in Ireland off the boat. And then there always seemed to be interesting people around. We always met artists and people interested in theatre. And I suppose the best visit was when I came back with a very small company called Ballet Caravan. And we were booked to dance for 2 weeks in the Gate Theatre. Unfortunately, there was an opera season, I think, at the time, and we had very, very bad audiences, but it was the time when Hilton and Michael were in charge of the Gate. And, of course, McLearmore was a terrific ballet fan, and they were so horrified that we were having bad audiences that they came every night. And, of course, we would wind up across the road in the local hostelry, and great conversations and fun. And then the climax, I think, was at the end of the season. We were entertained actually in their house to dinner. And I have a wonderful vision of Hilton carving with turkey and then sitting upstairs in the drawing room until, I think, at least 3 o'clock in the morning, discussing art in general and theatre and dance. And we all got slightly drunk. And I remember the best compliment I was ever paid was that McLearmore said he felt that my interpretation of the part of Der from Basil Feed reminded him of the beloved Anna Pavlova, and I've treasured that slightly drunken compliment to the end of my date. Oh, I love my feet. I think they serve me extraordinarily well. If they could talk, there'd be several volumes, I think. No, they've really served me incredibly well. Very few injuries, and they've literally danced me around the world. And it's funny because it has connotations of a point shoe in the vamp, and yet it's almost like my life has gone beyond the ballet into a wider context. And the fact that you've got the toes and the sole of the foot under, it sort of reflects what I do now, which is mostly walk elegantly around barefooted. So it really encapsulates the whole of my dancing life. It's tremendous.